Hi, I'm Laurie Ellison from Hudson Valley Bookkeeping, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to convert a tenant security deposit into rent. I will also teach you how to post if you are refunding a security deposit. All right, let's get started.
Okay, everybody, I'm going to show you how to convert a security deposit into rental income. First thing I want to explain to you is that I am in accountant view and I prefer it in that view. I think it's much better. So it's what I work in every day, and I just recommend you also work in that. Okay, so let's talk about why you would not return a security deposit. It could be that the tenant moved out and didn't pay their last month's rent. How common is that? And or they destroyed your property and now you are using that money to repair. So I'll have sometimes landlords say, well, it's not really income. I had to, you know, pay all this money to fix the place back up. You have to convert it to income. And then when you actually pay money out for the repairs, and if you lose a month or two of not being able to rent it, that's how you're taking your loss. Okay, so first thing you should get really comfortable in is running your balance sheet. That is where you would have your security deposits. Okay, so we will do this one, building one, unit one, security deposit. Right. So another couple of things I want to mention is that don't make one account that's just called security deposits payable and then lump everything in and out of there. It's so hard to figure out things from the past. Always break it down by the unit. And if you have maybe one person putting up their security deposit a month or two before someone moves out, don't put it to the unit again. I think you should really make it then unit and then the person's name. Okay, so let's check this one out. Okay, so this happened in 2021. Someone paid this, hopefully. You know, we're just gonna say they paid. Okay, so first scenario is that the $2,000 is not being returned and that you need to convert it into rental income because they moved out and didn't pay their last month's rent. So what I would recommend is, one, getting really good in your balance sheet. But then we went and looked at that. It was unit one, security deposit. Okay, so this is the easy way to make journal entries without having to actually go up here and make a journal entry, see, and know which way to debit or credit. We know we want to decrease this liability. So we're going to add a journal entry. Okay. And then I usually make my rental income by, let's see here, unit one, building one, right? Okay. So this now makes this $0. See this right here? Zero. And now if we went back and checked our balance sheet, building one, unit one is now zero. Okay, so that's your first scenario. And if, let's do this one like two different ways. Let's say they get part of it. I bet you I have like two people's. Oh, okay. $37.50. So let's say in this scenario, we're going to refund Tim Smith. That's who has this security deposit. He's moving out early. And we're only giving him back $1,750 and the rest we're keeping. How do you do that? So that's kind of like a split issue. Like you're giving back some of it, but not all of it. What did I say? We're going to give back $1,750. Okay, so this is building two, unit 3A. So the first thing we would do is let's do this. Let's do, we're going to add a journal entry for today. Portion of security deposit keeping for damages. So we're going to say $2,000. And this is building 2, unit 3A. Okay. So, and that's rent. So that's now where you're getting like you're claiming rental income, because when you get that money from the tenant for security deposit, it does not go on your income statement or your profit and loss. Same terminology. It goes into a liability account. Now we're saying we're not giving this back and we are not liable for this $2,000. That is when it gets converted to rent. Now you're going to have to, let's say you write a check or you Zelle or you ACH, who knows? I honestly, on a return of security deposit, would want that to be in a check. Reason being is that if they say they didn't get it, I'd be really hesitant to send that via Zelle and other ways. I would really want a cash check to go in your file or your scans of things. Like, here was the money they gave you. Here's a reason why you only, you know, should have some kind of correspondence of why you're keeping a certain amount. Building 138. Okay, here it is. Return of security deposit. Now, by sending this much back, this is not hitting your income statement. It is just taking away the portion of liability. So out of this $3,750, you're keeping $2,000. So if we run the P&L on this day, which I will do to show you, this will now be a rental income. Now, don't forget, you just need to post all your expenses against the repairs, and then whatever the difference is yours. And then here is the return of the security deposit. So this could be because you're keeping it. The other piece I said, because they skipped out and they didn't pay rent. And this could be, you're still going to post it to rental income. It's still turning into income because you're not giving it back. The way you bring down that income is by actually spending that money to repair. As you said, you would need that money. Okay, so now if I run the P&L, here's our $2,000. So we kept $2,000 on both accounts. One, because to convert rent, because they didn't really pay you. And here's $2,000 we kept because they did damages. All right, I hope that explains how to convert security deposits into rent and how to refund security deposits to your tenants. Have a great day.